What is the deal with these things? Hey guys, so we have this newer Honda Accord in the shop in for some diagnostics, and it appears to be a simple thing as we have our power ports over here and they are not working. So the first thing you do is you check the fuses. Fuses check out, but we check out the power port, no power. As soon as we go to the actual plug, it actually has power. So let's just check it out right now. So ignition off, ignition on, as power. So if the fuses are okay and the plug's okay, why are we not getting power at the power port itself? So when you guys are removing these, you'll see here, I'll show you on the bench, but I'll take a pick and there are little tabs that hold it on in place. And when you push them in, you'll be able to pull it out. So just going to recap and verify and show you. So this is the bad one. So we're just going to turn on the ignition. See, we have no power going to it, so let's go ahead and swap to the new one. Let's take a look at why this is happening. So looking at the power port, we can see that it has a few more things going on that you typically see. Usually what these are is they would have one prong will go to the center, and then that will give you your 12 volts, and then the outside is ground. So this is our ground over here. But we can see we can disassemble it into several parts, which is not very typical. Now, I do want to mention this does not look like a serviceable part. I actually don't know why we're able to take them apart this way. Because when we talked to Honda, they just sold us everything new. So as we keep disassembling it, so remember that's where positive is. There's a little bit more to it. So let's keep taking apart, see what we find. Well, broke that. So you can see inside, you have two pieces of metal. So here's the contact for our connector. And then we have this piece. And it looks like it's some sort of adhesive of some sort. So we're believing that the adhesive is basically the fuse. It's like a thermal thing. So as it heats up, it will let go because it's kind of like it's sprung almost. So if that's the center here, because this is ground. So that's center going to here, and you can see that it goes up here, and it's almost like it's sprung. So when the adhesive lets go, it stops making contact because we have this piece over here, this piece, and this piece. For whatever reason, it's probably for manufacturing purposes that you can disassemble it like this, because I don't see how they can sell us a new part to install into here and then put it back into service. Not like you'd really want to either. It's just one of those things that looking at it, like I would not recommend just spend the money and buy the new part. Like don't try to sand this, solder it together, because you're kind of defeating the purpose. You're not doing how it was engineered, because for all we know, I have not inspected the circuit of this car. There are two power ports or cigarette lighters in the car. One little cubby hole, one in the center console. They could be sharing the exact same fuse. So that fuse could be rated at like 20 amps, for example. These are probably rated at 10 each. So it could be the manufacturer, instead of running two fuses to the distribution panel, they decided to do one, and then this is now the fusible link. There's a lot of different reasons why they're doing what they're doing. My only suggestion is, if this happens to you, fuse checks out, you're checking power at the plug, you still have nothing going on, buy a new one of these from the dealership. Now we're verifying the new part. And you see now it works again just fine. So we're testing at the plug to make sure it wasn't the plug because the fuse checked out. And we were looking at this because there's an aftermarket amp and sub in here. So someone has gone ahead and intercepted the line, which is fine. You can do that. But you could obviously see that the fusible link in here has gone. So it needed the new piece. So here's the tricky thing. You can't just place it in and rotate it till you find the slot. So you kind of have to go all the way out and you're finding the slot. And it's so important to find that orientation because you need to be able to take these out again. So now you see that it's coming all the way through. So I'm going to put it out of, so that's the incorrect position. And I was just rotating it, like coming all the way out until I found that. You see the tab lift up. And that's it. And you go ahead and plug everything back in. So because we had a bunch of systems unplugged on the vehicle, we want to make sure that everything's okay. But as we can see, we have a bunch of trip codes, which makes sense. It's things like the shifter control module and the parking brake. Now, I did have them plugged in while I was working on it. Like, we can unscrew everything, plug the modules back in. But you always want to double check whenever you're doing some sort of repair or diagnostic that if you're even unplugging it, you could still trip codes on these newer vehicles. We're gonna go ahead and clear these and drive the vehicle around afterwards. All right, guys, let's go ahead and test this. So everything checks out. You can see that it is fixable. Nothing's wrong with your vehicle. Nothing's wrong with the wiring. Unfortunately, it just costs you a lot more money because you have to change out these parts. Now, unfortunately, you can't plug in things like tire inflators or air compressors, which draw very high. Which is a shame because those are what it's required on a lot of vehicles. Some vehicles don't have spare tires anymore and you have to reinflate tires. We've even seen on an Audi where the tire wasn't even inflated from factory. So be aware of your vehicle, read your owner's manual, what you can and can't do, and then you don't have to deal with things like this.